Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. Our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Dr. Bruce Ritchie, Church of Scotland Minister and tutor in Scottish Church History at Highland Theological College, the University of the Highlands and Islands.
Presiding Officer, today we are 5 days before Christmas. And I'd like to reflect on the faith of one of our great Scottish scientists, James Clerk Maxwell, who was brought up in Corsoc near in Dumfries and Galloway. Every morning, James and his wife Catherine had their own time for reflection. They read the Bible together, they prayed together, and when they were apart, James wrote to Catherine with his thoughts on the passage in question. And Maxwell was a deep-thinking Christian whose faith affected his science and vice versa. In his physics, he saw that the relationship between entities was part of the entity itself. And this field theory transformed physics from Einstein onwards. And in his faith, he believed similarly that the relationship between God and ourselves is what makes us what we are. We are not individual objects in isolation, but we are created to be persons in relation. What we are in relation to God, what we are in relation to each other, is what makes us persons. And Maxwell drove this relational way of thinking deep into his science and into his faith. And in one of his letters to Catherine, he applied it to the central feature of Christmas, namely that in Christian faith, Jesus is regarded as fully God and fully man. And for Maxwell, God with us in the enfleshed humanity of Christ enables us to know him. And for Maxwell, God with us in the divinity of Christ enables him to change and transform us. And he wrote these words to Catherine. He said, "For Jesus is man, that we may be able to look to him. And he is God, so that he can create us anew in his own image." And that was his faith, that Jesus enables humanity to know God. When we look at him, we see God himself. And as God, Jesus takes our broken humanity and renews it, in order that the fragile and broken and damaged sons and daughters of humanity might become the healed and forgiven sons and daughters of God. And Presiding Officer, that was Christmas for James Clerk Maxwell, the knowledge of God and the healing of humanity. And our task as people in Parliament is to reflect that divine mission, the mission of healing and renewal, the mission of peace and justice, a mission of reconciliation and forgiveness, a mission of wisdom and compassion. We're made for each other, and we're made for God. May God's blessing be on you, and may careful wisdom surround all your deliberations. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Ritchie.